Hello students, welcome to the third lesson of the third chapter from the subject Advanced Structural Analysis. So in this lesson, we'll solve the second problem of development of your stiffness matrix. Okay, so let's see how to develop the stiffness matrix for this problem. See now, this is similar to your first problem, what we have solved, but here the directions of the coordinate are slightly varying and the numbers also are varying. Okay, now it has how many coordinates? 3 coordinates. So your flexibility matrix will be of the order 3 into 3. So we can assume that these are our degree of redundancy, or what we can do is however many number of coordinates are there, that will be the size of your flexibility matrix. So this will be F11, F12, F13, F21, F22, F23, F31, F32 and F33 are the elements, general elements of your flexibility matrix. Now, whenever we are developing a flexibility or a stiffness matrix, what is that we'll be doing? We'll be developing the values column wise. Okay. So, to get the first column elements, what we have to do? To get in the first column elements, we have to apply unit force in the direction of the first coordinate, whereas all other coordinate forces should be equal to 0. So for example, if we take this as F1, this as F2 and this as F3, only for easier understanding we are naming them, okay, like this. So in F1, I am applying a unit force, and in 2 and 3, I am not applying any unit force. We should apply unit force and see what are the displacements that are developed in the 3 coordinates. Okay. So, how will this be? So, this is the beam. What are we basically doing? We are applying a unit displacement in the direction of the coordinate 1. So, this will be equal to 1. So, when I apply this, what will happen to this particular beam? It will contract by some amount, so that's equal to L by AE. By this much amount it will contract, right? So now if we want to write the elements F11, F21 and F31, so in the direction of first coordinate, in the direction of coordinate only you have your contraction, so this will be what? L by AE. So the length of this beam is given, so that's nothing but 2.5 by AE. Okay, so then coming to F21, there is no moment displacement here, nor there is a vertical displacement here, so this will be 0. So no moment, no rotation, no vertical displacement, therefore these two values will be 0. See, what is the meaning of this? You are applying unit force in the direction of first coordinate and trying to see what are the displacements in the coordinate 1, 2 and 3 respectively. Okay, now let's move ahead and see to get the second column element. So what we have to do to get the second column element, we have to apply unit force in the direction of your second coordinate. So all other coordinates, the forces should be equal to 0. So what is the second coordinate? It is a moment, anti-clockwise moment. So you have to apply a force moment equal to 1 and see what are the displacements occurring in these three coordinates. So what will happen if you apply a moment, unit moment? So let me draw the unit moment like this. So what is this unit moment doing to the beam? It is lifting the beam up. Okay. So it will be like this. Right, now I have to draw a tangent here from horizontal to tangent. If I want to come, what is the direction? This. So here there will be a displacement like this. Now because of the moment, the displacement value is what? L square by 2EI, and the rotational value is what? L by EI. Okay, in horizontal direction there will be nothing. So what are your elements? F12, F22, F32. What is the meaning? We are applying unit force in the second coordinate and trying to see what are the displacements developed in the first, second and third coordinate. So in the first coordinate, that is in horizontal direction, there is nothing. So it will be zero. In the second coordinate is a moment. So here this is a anticlockwise moment. So here also you are getting an anticlockwise rotation. Okay, that will be plus L by E I. Coming to the third coordinate, this is a vertical coordinate downward. Okay, so but we have a vertical displacement that is upward. So it will be L square by minus L square by 2E I. Okay, so what will this value be? 2.5 by E I. And this will be minus 2.5 whole square by 2E I. So how much will this value come up to? Minus 3.125 by E I. If you just complete the calculation. So then finally what we have to do to get the third column elements. What we have to do to get the third column elements? Apply unit force in the direction of third coordinate. The other two coordinates, the force should be equal to zero. So what is third coordinate? A vertical downward force. So you have to apply a vertically downward force equal to unity like this and see how your beam will deflect. So your beam will deflect like this. So this is your vertical displacement. It will be equal to L cube by 3EI and there will be a rotation here. So with respect, you have to always put the direction from horizontal to the tangent. Okay, so this will be equal to L square by 2EI. Now see your elements F13, F23 and F33. What is the meaning? You are applying unit displacement. You are applying unit force in the third coordinate and trying to see what are the displacements in the first, second and third coordinate. Okay, so in the first coordinate there will be nothing, no horizontal. In the second coordinate, what is the second coordinate? A moment, anti-clockwise. Here, this is a moment here, rotation here, but this is clockwise. So it will be what? Minus L square by E I. And the last one, vertical displacement here is downwards. Here the coordinate also is downwards, so that will be plus L cube by 3E I. So this value is minus 2.5 whole square by 2E I. So how much will it come up to? It will come in above minus 3.125 by E I. And this will be what? 2.5 whole cube by 3E I. So this will come up to 5.2083 by EI. What we have to do? Just put it in our final matrix. So what are the values? So this is 2.5 by AE, then 0, 0. Come on to the second, 0, 2.5 by EI, then minus 3.125 by E. Coming to the last one, 0 minus 3.125 by EI, 5.2083 by EI. Now if you observe, it is a diagonally symmetric matrix. So this is your diagonal elements. So observe here, see, this is a diagonally symmetric matrix. So whatever you have done is correct. Understood. Now in this problem, there is a slight additional thing what you have to do. See, E, I, A are already given in this problem. So you need to substitute it and get your F value, numerical F value. Okay, that's important. Now how will we do that? How will you convert your E into, E is given into GPA. GPA is nothing but 10 raised to 9 MPa. Okay. So MPa is nothing but Newton per meter square. Now, if you want to convert this to Newton per mm square, you have to divide by 10 power 6. Okay, so this will be what? Into 10 power 3 Newton per mm square. So this is your value of E. Then, what is that? A is given as how much? 250 centimeter square. So if you want to come from centimeter to mm, it's into 10. Okay, so it will be what? 250 into 10 square mm square. This is your A. So what will be E into A? 200 into 10 power 3 into 250 into 10 power 2. So that will give you a value of 5000 into 10 power 6 Newton. Now if you want to convert it to kilo Newton, what will happen? 5, this 3, if they go to kilo Newton, so what will happen? 5 into 10 power 6 kilo Newton. Right. Now similarly, I. How much is I given to us? 12500 centimeter power 4. So what happens? 12500 into 10 power 4 mm power 4. Next, we want what? E into I. So what will happen? 200 into 10 power 3 into I value is 12500 into 10 power 4. You get a value equal to 2.5 into 10 power 13 Newton mm square. Now, from Newton to kilonewton, 10 into 10 power 3. From mm square to meter square into 10 power 6. So, into 10 power 3 into 10 power 6 into 10 power. Sorry, this will be minus 6. This will be minus 3. So, if you want to convert from Newton to Newton mm square to kilonewton meter square, this will be into 10 power minus 3. For this, it will be into 10 power minus 6. So, 10 power minus 9. 13 minus 9, it will be 4. So, 2.5 into 10 power 4 kilonewton meter square. So, what you do, substitute this AE value and EI value in this particular matrix, you will get your final flexibility matrix. So, it will be 0.500 minus 125, 0 minus 125 and 208.33 into 10 power minus 6. This will be your final flexibility matrix. Hope you understood how to develop a flexibility matrix for a given coordinate system.